What's up, guys? It's the man, the myth, the Clay Dog here. I literally just thought of doing that intro. I've never done that before, but I thought that'd be fun. Anyways, hey guys, it's Clayton here. Welcome back to a new video. Welcome back to a new concert vlog. Today is Saturday. I think it's July 27th of 2024. Yes, it is for certain July 27th of 2024. And I'm about to go to my 49th concert of the year. I'm going to Cush Hill. That is a house venue in Tacoma, Washington. It's going to be about a 40-minute drive or so, but I'm in a rush because I got to go because soon after I get there, music's going to start. So I'm going to try to see all the bands. There's four bands playing. Only two of them I know of. Only two of them I've seen before. There's going to be Blind Heresy. This will be my third time seeing them. The first time I actually saw them was at Cush Hill. Second time I saw them was in some backyard in, I think it may have been the U District, on 420, April 20th, a few months ago. And then the other band that I've seen before is Stone Yard. I've only seen them once before. That was April 14th in a basement in Tacoma. And then I also saw them a few weeks ago, just at a concert. They weren't playing, but I saw the bassist and the guitarist slash singer underneath the bridge on July 7th. But yeah, now I'm gonna be seeing them play for the second time. Anyways, let's go to a concert. Also, this hat is new. I got it yesterday in Leavenworth. Let me know if it's cringe. All right, here I am, just parked down the street from Cush Hill.
Those classes have like six people.
I don't know.
Like,
oh, sure, yeah. Yeah.
Cush Hill. All right. Lou.
Sorry.
Are you good?
I'm guessing that means you can hear me. Woohoo!
Okay.
bye.
Yes.
So the next song that we're gonna play for you is a little bit of a newer one. So, and this is a fun one. This is a fun one. It's a real fun one. So, Elijah, you haven't heard this one yet.
My favorite song, let's go!
No, you haven't heard it yet.
Oh, I'm so excited!
My belt broke.
Thank you.
to. Because the chorus is just, I can't take it when I miss you, babe. And yeah, you just need to know that and you're golden. And if you want to know more of it, you can listen to it on our Spotify.
What?
Or on all platforms. Because it's there too. This song is named after a food that Kenny and I had today, and it's Kenny's favorite word, and it's his favorite food, and it's called yakisoba. We'll be right back. Okay, we're gonna slow it down a bit for the only time of the. Anyways, okay. This is a very whimsical song, so get whimsical with it. Get flowy with it, yeah. Come on now.
Thank you.
weird, okay? Because I'm not a part of this one at all. So I'm going to join you guys in the audience, and we're going to go crazy for our little singer, Ozzy!
We'll be right back. Thank you. guys, we're Sunbather Die. Thanks for having us. Oh my gosh. Give it up one more time for drivers. Yeah. We got Blind Heresy up next. Oh. And then we got our besties in Stoneyard last. They're the best, you guys. Love you guys. Awesome. Okay, we got a couple more for you. So really sad news. We don't have any music or any merch or anything out. So, I know, really upset. We're hopefully gonna get some out soon, but the only way you'll know though is by following our Instagram. So if you don't do that, please do that so we can see you at another show at some point. But also, the other bands tonight have some super sick merch. I think it's right over there. I'm pretty sure. I don't really know where you guys put your merch, but definitely go buy some of that. It's super sick. We got a couple more for you. Stone Yard, you guys.
Hi, Clayton.
Real.
Oh. Crashed on the floor with Travis.
That was funny. Wait, that was.
Yes, it is.
Thank you. turn it up. This next one's a new one, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah!
Josh, you ready, mate?
Thank you.
Feeling the slow song, you guys are.
Hectic!
Thank you.
No, because I was like, I don't know Anna well enough, but I feel like you would be able to reach out to her and ask her to say why.
What's up, Clayton?
Ooh, how's it going? It's good.
All right.
I mean, the mix sounds good out here. I think they still do like
Thank you.
at Stone Yard? We're very thankful to be here at Cush Hill. I'm not afraid to
Take a big step forward. You got a big heart from a childlike wonder. We're happy to be here in Tacoma, the greatest city on earth. This next song is called. Thank you. We're Stone Yard.
Yeah, you are!
Thanks, Paul and Cush Hill for having us. Yeah, we got merch. We got shirts. We got two new singles out on everything. And yeah, thank you all for coming out.
Thank you.
so much.
Yeah, love. All summer to Rochelle. No, for real, for real. Oh, this is gonna be the best part though, is when I go back to school, I get to tell all my friends about my cool musician band.
Checking, testing, Zo. Testing, microphone,
test,
check
out. What was it?
Oh, I feel like
where's the camera?
It's right here.
Bro, what the
we're
fuck?
Just using the microphone on the phone.
Okay, hell yeah.
Check.
Run it up.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah.
Wanna try it?
I'm ready to rock steady, baby.
All right.
How's the lighting?
I think it looks pretty good.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, you look mysterious. All right.
One sec.
Fire. Hell yeah.
All right.
That's a cruiser.
Mm-hmm.
All right, today is Saturday, July 27th of 2024. I'm Clayton, and here I am standing with Blind Heresy, band from, where are you guys from?
Tacoma,
Washington. What are your names?
Lorenzo.
Josh.
David.
And, I mean, I know what instruments you guys play, but for those watching, what are your parts in the band?
Vocals and guitar.
I play drums.
Bass, sometimes vocals.
Bass.
Most
all right.
Of the time vocals.
So you guys just finished playing a show at Cush Hill. What did you think of, have you guys played here before?
Played once before. It was our second show. We fucking love here in the community. There's not too many places to play in Tacoma. That's why we're up in Seattle most of the time. But this is one of those spots that you just, if they post a show, you gotta be here.
You guys were in Seattle last night, right?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Under the Bridge?
Mm-hmm.
How was that show? I wasn't able to make it.
It was fucking amazing.
That show was good. Because we
know Stoney's puzzle.
It's not actually his brain, but it's not even brain.
Stoney's birthday. He's in, Shattered Jaw. They just started. They're sick as fuck. Hardcore music. Stoney, frontman's birthday. That was the show at the Bridge, and it was awesome.
Sweet. Well, happy belated birthday to, what's his name?
Stoney.
Happy birthday, Stoney. Was that your first time playing at the Bridge?
No. It's like the 17th.
Wow.
Yeah, we play there like way too often.
Okay.
We posted a show there once, and like our homie Dallin commented, they about to start charging y'all rent.
All right, so you guys play there pretty frequently. Yeah. What do you guys think of playing underneath the Bridge? Like, what's it like compared to playing at a different DIY venue like Cush Hill in the living room?
Well, mostly because the bills are just all the homies. So it's just like hella nonchalant. And like, it's free. So it's free.
It's awesome, yeah. Cush Hill house venue's a little more organized, and it's still DIY. But like if DIY was organized, and Bridge Show is just a bunch of people that just want to play loud music. Just find a generator, find some PAs, and get a bill together.
How long have you guys been playing together?
Like this time last year?
Yeah, just about a year.
About a year.
And did you guys like know each other before you like got together as a band?
Yeah, these two dudes have been my best friends since like early middle school.
Okay.
It's like 8 years now. And
wow. And how old are you guys?
21.
He's 21.
21
in
3 weeks.
20.
Almost there. Awesome. All right. You guys have any plans? Do you guys have an album out yet? Or
we have an EP.
EP.
Yeah.
We have an EP. We released two singles, put them in a little bundle with an EP. It was our first 5 songs ever written. And for us, we named it Disposable because that's kind of how we feel towards it.
Mm.
Because it was our first 5 songs. We hate it now. We hate them all. But they're
not
out.
Murder Scars and Throw Me Outside.
Pretty good. Yeah, that's pretty good. We're tired of playing them, though. So that was just trying to, because we knew if we recorded our newer songs, then we would have never recorded our first 5. So we just wanted to get those out of the way.
Okay, that's good. So, was it sort of like a block or like a creative block you had to get over, or like in order to get to your new stuff?
We moved on. Like we wrote more songs. It's just like we knew that if we recorded our newer songs, we would, yeah, like you said,
because we didn't record. We made our first 5, and then
made like 10
months,
more songs.
Like 5 months later, recorded for the first time.
Oh, okay.
But we have five new songs that we just recorded, and we're gonna do like a couple singles and then maybe drop an EP as well.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's hella soon. And then hopefully an album soon after that.
Awesome. Lastly, unless I think of anything else, do you guys have any, like, who are your, like, best inspirations for your music?
Boom. It's crazy. We actually all have completely different music tastes.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, that's honestly, I think the most interesting thing about us is that we all have such completely different music tastes that we all come together because we've been homies for so long and respect each other's perspectives on music, and we make something. We like, what's the word? I don't know. We just mesh together. We make it work. Like, you want, you like this kind of music, you like this kind of music, I like this kind of music. How can we like put all those genres into one?
All right.
And that's kind of how it comes about. And if we have this rule, because we're a three piece, it makes things a lot easier. It's just ratio, like. If I want to do a solo and both of them are like, no, then it's like, fuck, I'm outnumbered. So.
All right.
And, yeah, and that's how we make all of our decisions.
What's your biggest inspiration, though?
I don't know. I really like Turnstile.
Turnstile.
But then I also like Audioslave. I like a lot of classic rock. But I also like a lot of softer shit too. I'm all over the place, but I think classic rock is where I'm influenced most in our music.
Is that the kind of stuff you're like raised listening to?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it was 99.9 when I would get.
Is that KISS?
Yeah.
Or KISW? Is that it?
Yeah.
Or,
shout out Kevin.
Kevin. He played Throw Me Out.
Sweet.
That was tight. But yeah, it was crazy. Yeah, because my stepdad, every time, every day to football practice, he would play 99.9. I didn't know anything about it, but I was so young, and it just stuck with me, and I never listened to any music in my life, and yeah, I'm grateful for it.
That's awesome. Do you have anything else you guys want to add?
Josh's inspirations, bro.
Yeah.
Can we get a shout out for our sexy ass drummer, motherfucking Joshua?
As far as what I'm into, a lot of like 90s and like 2000s, like punk and hardcore.
Let's go.
Oh shit.
But like, you can't forget about Lil Peep.
I'll never forget about Lil Peep. That's what I like grew up on.
Little
I
bit
guess.
Of smoke perk, bro.
It was like, yeah, that's generally what I did grow up on, was like SoundCloud rap. Yeah, like Lil Peep.
He used to be a rapper. Like for
really?
A, for a day and a half.
For a day and a half, all right.
He's actually wet. He's actually wet.
Check out, what's the freestyle?
56 Degrees Freestyle.
On SoundCloud only. Chase Rich. With
Chase
a dollar
Rich sign. Chase Rich, mm-hmm. SoundCloud, 56,
nickname,
what?
All high Degree. School was Beans.
Freestyle.
All right.
Yeah.
Beans?
Beans.
Yeah, Beans.
Beans, all right.
That's me.
How did you get that nickname?
I got no goddamn idea.
Bro, I'm trying to be humble, but it was me. I made up Beans, bro.
I remember we were in the hot tub or something.
Yeah, I never wanted to tell you because I felt bad.
You guys said you've known each other since middle school?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's awesome.
All right. Yeah, Lil Pump was my first love. And
Lil Pump, first love. Show
him. That's Lil Pete.
That's Lil Pete. It says love. Wait, get in the light. Lean back.
Yes, sir.
There we go.
Mm-hmm. But as of recent, some of my favorite bands right now, like on the punk side, like Distillers, fucking amazing. Pennywise, probably one of my all-time favorites. As far as, yeah, a lot of like 2000s hardcore, like Hatebreed, Terror, shit in that essence. And
yeah, when it comes to drums,
probably, and again, one of my like all-time favorite bands, Silverstein, their drummer Paul Koffler, mm-hmm. is a fucking unit, and is one of the best emo, like most hardcore bands to ever do it.
Awesome.
David?
N.W.?
Type shit.
He's the LMFAO.
First and foremost.
Soulja Boy for teaching me how to do.
You said Snowboy Frosty?
Oh, no, it's Frosty the Snowman. Mm-hmm. Dude, for a while I was listening to Faye Webster and like Phoebe Bridgers, now and then like Bob Marley. and like your arms are my cocoon type shit.
You feel like it's like pretty diverse where you get your inspiration
yeah,
from?
But I started playing bass like when we started the band, so I never felt like I was technically good enough to have like an inspiration.
Okay,
so I just played whatever Lorenzo played, and then now it's just tight.
That's cool. So no, yeah, you're really great at playing. It's fun
Thanks,
to watch
bro.
You play. Yeah, especially I think earlier I was telling you about what is it at the 420 house show you guys played at. You played a bass line from Sick Transit Gloria from Brand New.
Brand New, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, Josh actually put me on to Brand New.
Alright.
He was my inspiration.
Josh is
my inspiration.
Boom.
I hate both of them.
You inspire each other.
Yeah.
On some overarching shit, Clayton is my inspiration.
Clayton is my inspiration.
Yeah, can we interview you?
If you want to. Yeah.
I think I stopped the recording. Okay. We're recording now. If it wasn't recording,
Josh,
that'd be so sad.
All right,
Clayton.
With my band, Blind Heresy.
Mm-hmm. And your names?
Clay Dog.
Jewel.
What?
Right, so why do you like interviewing? Oh gosh. I love music and it's cool to hear about like artists and like where like the mind behind the music, I guess. Yeah, like where does it come from? It's interesting, like I'll be like working out and just listening to music and I'll be at a show and it's like so surreal like being with the actual band. The real people are right there, so it's cool to think like where does that song come from?
Yeah.
Or like, who are those people? So, it's cool to like get to know people like that.
Hello.
Yeah.
Because I feel like music is so like, you know, everyone fucks with music. It's such like a universal thing.
Yeah, that's so true.
Yeah, like what moves people?
Yeah, and that's what I realized too. Like we're playing all these shows, you meet all these bands, you realize like it's just another dude.
Yeah.
That's what you're saying earlier, how like you're so equal.
Yeah, I've got like a hard time feeling like everyone's like better than me or like,
yeah,
I don't know. But like lately, I've been realizing like we're all equal. I don't need to be so like.
You're the fucking man, under Clayton.
Pressure. I don't know.
No, for sure. Dude.
Yeah.
Hell.
Yeah.
Because you're better than Josh for sure.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, 100%.
I've had not the same shade of red. It's more like orange. Turns out when you bleach purple hair, it turns like this ugly orange with some like. Some red tips at the top, but you got good hair. I love it.
Wait, no, because we dyed his hair purple. It's
really?
Blonde right now.
It's burgundy.
And that shit hella turned like
Fuck
red at
guys.
The tips or some shit.
Yeah. When was it purple?
Like red and green.
It was purple when you first dyed your hair, kind
of.
No.
Yeah, I mean like 4 or 5 months ago it was purple.
Okay.
Where are you from, Clayton?
Yeah, I'm from Enumclaw, Washington.
Enumclaw, Washington.
It's about like a 45-minute drive today.
God damn.
But here we're in Tacoma right now. Yeah. If I went to Seattle, it'd be like 50 minutes to an hour. But like the other day, I drove to Ballard, and that was like an hour and 15-minute drive. And then finding parking sucked.
What made you come drive that far here?
For here?
I was getting a phone call, bro. I don't know if
you can. No, yeah. What made you come down here? It's 40 minutes.
I only know two of the bands, but there was you guys, Blind Heresy, and then Stoneyard. That was my first.
Yeah.
Tonight was my second time seeing Stoneyard.
When did you first see them?
That was April 14th at a basement house show in Tacoma.
Oh, Karashi, Alex Vile.
Yes, and Swamplight.
Oh, Stoneyard was there?
Yeah. That was the first band that
we
played.
That's where we were there. He was there.
No, it was like so cool. Honestly, like I was like just standing outside the basement, the venue, whatever. And I was planning on just like hanging out outside for a bit, like during the show. But the bassist, I can't remember his name, but bassist for Stoneyard was like, hey, you're Clayton, right?
No
and he's like, I've seen like some of your videos and like he asked if I could get a full set. And like that was the first time anyone's ever done
that's
that.
That's fire.
So, that was like pretty cool.
Dude, hell yeah.
But that was like, so I saw that they're playing a show tonight on top of you guys too.
Yeah.
Well, on top of you guys. but yeah, I was like, I just love music. I love the energy at like house shows. It's like unmatched. Like, I was at Showbox Soto, or no, I was at the Showbox on July 5th, just earlier this month. And it was a good show, but like, shows like that, they're almost like the same at every venue. Sometimes the venues look different.
True.
But like, at a house show, just the energy is different. It's just like
Absolutely.
So
what is it?
It's warm, it's communal.
Yeah.
It's awesome.
It's intimate, that's what
yeah.
I'm looking for.
Yeah.
And I just love being at shows.
It's like, beautiful.
So filled with life being at shows. So.
I love.
And then I just like to try to capture the experiences. So like I get videos of the band and just try to capture like the atmosphere of what it's like to go to a show too.
Fire. Dude, you're way better at answering questions.
Thanks. Oh. I wasn't prepared. I was.
It's actually funny. That's just on camera. You. Zoe's just texting right now. It's crazy.
That is crazy.
I'm not texting nobody.
Yeah.
All right, you want to switch? Bro?
I'm on animal. I'm on Animal Crossings.
Get in there.
All right, Zoe. Bro, you made it weird, bro.
You made it weird. You switched the camera on me.
All right. Wait, should we get some goofy compilation clips?
Yeah,
I'm down.
I feel
here.
Like, it's Kickstand Josh. Here. It's Kickstand you on the beer.
Yeah, do a handstand and then they'll lift up your legs.
I don't got that.
You could just lay. No, you can't handstand, but they'll be balancing you.
Yeah, we'll catch you. You put your hands on the floor, we'll lift you up.
Okay. You got this, Josh?
Two. No.
Three, go. Alright, do a push-up or something. Yeah, that's Clayton.
I'm... Alright, you're done.
Oh my gosh.
I'm not behind the camera anymore.
Yeah, we switched it on him. We're interviewing him.
Oh, what up, Caleb? Alright.
Cool. Yeah, that's good.
All right. Well,
Taylor,
well, that concludes this. It's fun hanging out with you guys.
Oh yeah, Bob, bro. Get out of there. I thought they were closed down.
No, they're back.
They're back.
No, it's been a day.
No
right?
way.
Yeah, they got shut down.
All right. Let's close it out for Clayton, Dave. Yeah, come. So you're the lead guitarist.
No, lead singer.
Yeah, lead singer.
Yeah, I actually started this band. Hey, guys.
Yeah, we got Kaylin, the lead singer.
Yeah, I started all of this.
I'm the singer of Blind Heresy.
I'm the lead singer of Blind Heresy. I'm the master puppeteer.
She tells us all what to do.
Yeah.
We don't even know how to play our instruments. She's the fucking...
Yeah, you're just like, you're hooked up to like three instruments in the back, in the basement. All DI.
Yeah, I do it all. Yeah, okay, I want some. Alright,
later.
All right. Have you one. Alright, well, thanks for the interview, guys. It was fun hanging out. Yeah.
Damn.
That was nice. Good shit.
Hell yeah.
All right.
Thank you, Clayton.
Thank you. Have a good night.
Have a good night.
Peace. Woo. Bye.
No, what? All right, good morning. It is now Sunday, July 28th, and it's 1:16 in the morning, and I'm finally walking back to my car. Yeah, I mean, the show ended probably like around 11 or so, but I've just been hanging out and talking to people for like the last 2 hours. It's been a pretty fun time. Really great show. And now I've been to 49 shows this year. It's crazy. But yeah, just lots of times I've had a hard time feeling like I actually belong when I'm at shows, and tonight was not that case. I had a really great time seeing friends and meeting new people, and I wasn't just questioning like, gosh, does everyone hate me? Because like, those thoughts are in my head a lot. That shows. Also, it's pretty cold. But, yeah, my car is just right over there. Anyways, it was a great show. Oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to get a video of the moon because it looks so cool. See that? Well, it looks better in person, but gosh, that's beautiful. All right, well, here's the end of the concert vlog. Thank you for watching. It is now 1:19 in the morning. Says it's gonna be like a 36-minute drive to get back home. And my ETA, if I'm like driving right now, is gonna be 1:55 in the morning. I'm tired, so I had fun talking, but I was like,
yeah, definitely pretty tired, so time to head home. Anyways, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.